Hello everyone, welcome to Dynamic Study. This is class number 20 and this is the fifth part of the video series on important autobiographical works in English literature. We have already discussed a lot of important works and today we will cover some more. Okay, so let's begin. The first work of today is The Road to Wigan Pier. This was published in 1937. In the previous video, I have discussed a memoir written by George Orwell, Down and Out in Paris and London. And this is also an autobiographical account written by George Orwell, published in 1937. This is also divided into two parts. Now, the first part is about the life of the working class in the industrial belt of Lancashire and Yorkshire. And the second part talks about the relevance of socialism in improving their conditions. So this is all about the industrial workers, the poor condition of the industrial workers and how it can be improved. That is the basic theme of the two parts of this work. Now, about the title, Road to Wigan Pier, Orwell has given an explanation. Orwell himself has given an explanation. Now, what is it? I have quoted it here. Orwell said, "I am afraid I must tell you that Wigan Pier doesn't exist. I made a journey specially to see it in 1936 and I could not find it. It did exist once, however, and to judge from the photographs, it must have been about 20 feet long. Wigan is the middle name of the mining areas." So this is how Orwell has explained the title. Okay. Next, Look Homeward Angel, subtitled as A Story of the Buried Life. It was published in 1929. This is an autobiographical novel written by Thomas Wolfe. An important thing is that the title is taken from Milton's Lycidas. Look Homeward Angel, this title is taken from Milton's Lycidas. This novel was originally titled as The Building of a Wall. The novel is written in three parts and it has total 40 chapters. It was set in the town Asheville in North California. This is a fictional city, Asheville in North California. And the narrator of this novel is Eugene Gent. Eugene Gent is the son of a stone cutter. And this novel is about the biography of Gent's parents. Gent talks about the lives of his parents. That is the beginning of this novel. Look Homeward Angel. Next one is To Sir With Love, published in 1959. This is an autobiographical novel by Edward Braithwaite. Edward Braithwaite has written this novel in 22 chapters. Now, this novel is based on the author's own experience as a teacher in a green slate school. And the novel is about the protagonist Ricky Braithwaite, who is an engineer in an oil refinery but later leaves this job and becomes a teacher. So from an engineer, Ricky becomes a teacher. So that is about To Sir With Love. Next is The Towers of Trebizond, published in 1956. This is a partly autobiographical novel written by Rose Macaulay and it is her last novel. This is important because this novel won James Tait Black Memorial Prize for Fiction. Laurie is the name of the narrator and it deals with the adventurous journey of a group of people from Istanbul to Trebizond. Now, where is this Trebizond? Trebizond is actually a city on the Black Sea coast of northeastern Turkey. So, Trebizond is a city in Turkey. And it deals with the journey of a group of people who travels from Istanbul to Turkey, Istanbul to Trebizond. The opening line is very famous, "Take my camel, dear." This is how the novel opens. नेक्स्ट वन इज अर्थली पावर्स, पब्लिश्ड इन 1980. दिस इज एन ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल नॉवल रिटन बाय एंथोनी बर्जेस. दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज इट वॉज शॉर्टलिस्टेड फॉर बुकर प्राइज एंड द प्रोटागोनिस्ट इज केनेथ टूमी. Kenneth Toomey is a homosexual writer of 81 years old. Now, Kenneth Toomey himself narrates his life story in 82 chapters. Very interesting division of plot, right? 81-year-old narrator tells his life story in 82 chapters. The opening line is very famous. It was the afternoon of my 81st birthday and I was in bed with my catamite when Ali announced that the archbishop had come to see me. Catamite means the male homosexual partner. So very shocking opening line. It was the afternoon of my 81st birthday and I was in bed with my catamite. At that time, Ali announced that the archbishop had come to see me. Next one, The English Teacher, published in 1945. You all know this is a famous autobiographical novel written by R.K. Narayan. And it is dedicated to his wife, Rajam. The protagonist is Krishnan. Krishnan is the teacher. And it talks about Krishnan's emotional maturation after the death of his wife and how he learns to communicate with her spirit. So Krishnan is the English teacher and it talks about his own psychological development, his own emotional maturation when his wife died and how he learns to communicate with her spirit. So a kind of transpersonal communication is there. And it is important because it is based on the myth of Savitri and Satyavan. You all know the famous story of Savitri and Satyavan. So on the myth of this myth, on the basis of Savitri Satyavan myth, this novel is written, The English Teacher. The next one is Oranges Are Not the Only Fruit. This is a very, very important and famous work written by Jeanette Winterson, published in 1985. This is an autobiographical novel. Now, the protagonist's name is also Jeanette. Jeanette is a young girl who is destined to become a missionary. She has a belief that she is destined to become a missionary. But what happens when she reaches her adolescence, she falls in love with another girl at that time. So that is the kind of contrast. What she is destined to be, a missionary is supposed to be devoid of all these kind of material desires or earthly pleasures. But what happens in reality that she falls in love with another girl. So that is a kind of homosexual relationship between these two. And it is the coming of age story of a lesbian girl. Yes, Jeanette is a lesbian girl. Now, this work is famous because it has numerous allusions to some major works of English literature. You all know the major famous names of these works. For example, Jane Eyre, A Streetcar Named Desire by Tennessee Williams, Goblin Market by C.G. Rossetti, Beowulf, Middlemarch by George Eliot. So all these kind of, what we say, the canonical works of English literature, they are alluded in this novel of Jeanette Winterson. That's why it becomes important. And another thing is that this novel is divided into 8 sections. And very interestingly, the 8 sections are titled after the first 8 books of the Bible. Now, the story is about the relationship of a lesbian girl and the title is taken from Bible. That is the very contrast. Okay. And so, you can also read a detailed summary of this novel if you want. This is a very interesting plot line. Next, The Town and the City, published in 1950. This is the semi-autobiographical novel written by Jack Kerouac. You all know Jack Kerouac is famous for writing the novel On the Road, right? So this is another novel, the semi-autobiographical novel by Jack Kerouac, The Town and the City. Now, what are this town and the city? The town represents the early Beat generation writers, and the city represents a number of figures of this early Beat generation circle, like Allen Ginsberg, William Burroughs. So this is all about the Beat generation poets. Okay, it was influenced by Thomas Wolfe. The next important autobiography is The Private Life of an Indian Prince, published in 1953. This is written by Mulk Raj Anand. Now, this is not exactly an autobiography. Mulk Raj Anand has written autobiographical works like Seven Summers. Okay, so this is not an autobiography, but it has some autobiographical tone. You can say it is semi-autobiographical or partly autobiographical. It has some allusions from Mulk Raj Anand's own life. Now, what is this all about? It deals with the abolition of princely state system in India. Okay, the next one is Nectar in a Sieve, published in 1954, a famous semi-autobiographical novel by Kamala Markandeya. The narrator is Rukmani. It deals with the love story of Rukmani and Nathan and the struggle of Rukmani to feed her children. It was set in the backdrop of urbanization in India, and an important thing is that the title Nectar in a Sieve is taken from Coleridge's poem Work Without Hope. The next one is Tom Brown's School Days, published in 1857. This is a novel written by Thomas Hugh. It was set in Rugby School, and Tom's character is based on Thomas Hugh's own brother George. So that's why it is autobiographical. Tom Brown is actually Hugh's own brother George Hugh. Now, how is Tom? Tom is an energetic, stubborn and kind-hearted man. He is more athletic than intellectual. Okay. The next one is Seven Pillars of Wisdom, published in 1926. This is an autobiographical novel written by Thomas Edward Lawrence, T.E. Lawrence. Now, the title Seven Pillars of Wisdom is taken from Book of Proverbs. And a famous film is made based on this novel. The film is titled as Lawrence of Arabia. Now, what is this novel all about? It talks about the experience of Lawrence himself as a liaison officer with rebel forces during the Arab revolt against Ottoman Turks. So, he was a commander or a colonel. He was associated with military regime. And he talks about his experience as an officer when he served against the Ottoman Turk. That is the basis of the plot of the novel Seven Pillars of Wisdom. The next is John Barleycorn, published in 1913. It is also an autobiographical novel written by Jack London. The title is taken from a British folk song. The song is also titled as John Barleycorn, and it talks about, very interesting, it talks about Jack London's experiences of drinking alcohol in various stages of his life. So alcohol is the central theme or motive of this work. That is about John Barleycorn. There are some other important autobiographical works like The Prelude, Childe Harold's Pilgrimage by Lord Byron, The Home and the World, Joyce's Portrait, etc. There are numerous autobiographical works. I have only talked about some of the major works which are lesser known but very important. And I would advise you to read about all these works in detail. I have only jotted down some of the major points or major informations. You must read on your own about all these works. And these are also the masterpieces, The Prelude, Childe Harold's Pilgrimage. These are the most important works of not only in the field of autobiographical works, but also in English literature. So I am requesting you to read about all these works in as much detail as possible. Okay, And I hope this video series have helped you a lot to gather some of the major informations about all these works. There are a number of autobiographical works. There is no limit. I have already listed a few here, and please read about all those things on your own. This video is for your guidance, and you must read on your own. You must do a thorough research on your own about all these works. Okay, I hope you will do that. So thank you very much. This is the end of today's class. Keep on watching Dynamic Study. Keep on learning. We will meet very soon in our next class. Please like this video, share this video with your friends, and also don't forget to put your views in the comment section. Have a nice day. Bye bye.